Hi, I'm Purnam Sheth. I'm the Vice President of Engineering at Pelican Imaging, a startup here in Mountain View. In my past history, I've worked at large companies such as Cisco, BlackBerry, Bell Northern Research, Northern Telecom, and typically in a software R&D role, driving products to delivery. Many of the products that I have worked on have encompassed anything from small startups to large established code bases that are undergoing large revolutions. Languages such as C, C++, Java, and operating systems from Linux, Android, BlackBerry OS, Cisco iOS, really the whole gambit. The key critical component in many of these, when we look at both languages as well as OSs, is really the ability to transition in from a quality perspective, a tooling perspective, from both small to large. I've actually, with my development teams, used Coverity, whether it be in an agile scrum model, very iterative, or a waterfall model. At each particular point where a developer's writing code, as he's unit testing, can run Coverity right integrated in the cycle. What we found works really well, as you get the number of false positives down, as you get the database with all the warnings established at a very low rate, is that it becomes even easier for developers to do it as part of their normal process. After I've compiled the code, what most developers end up doing is, well, I got a choice. I can start unit testing and find some bugs, or I can run a tool like Coverity, find some bugs really quickly, and then start working on the harder bugs. That takes a little bit of time for every engineer to get to that point where they feel that the ROI is there. But once they start and once they get going through it, it definitely makes a big impact. So this actually allows a very iterative development process, whether it be within an agile waterfall, agile scrum, or a waterfall type of environment. Key thing is actually being able to ensure that the right reporting's in place, the right feedback mechanisms are in place, and in fact, even the right safeguards are in place, so that as part of your nightly build or your weekly build, you're still also running other types of Coverity or other tool runs, such that you can then do comparisons and checkpoints against previous weeks to ensure that you're driving your warnings down to a very low level. You know, one thing that is really clear, and it's obvious, but you know, sometimes it's just not seen, is that, you know, writing good code, compiler warnings, static analysis warnings, it's good hygiene, right? If you don't deal with it every day, after about several weeks or months, your teeth are going to be really messy and you're going to have to go get a lot of fillings. This is the same thing with tool practices, whether it be static analysis, other kinds of checkers as well. As long as it's integrated in the cycle, it's easy to use, it's seamless, those are the things that, you know, there's a very low barrier to not wanting to use it. But obviously, if there's 1,000 warnings outstanding, no developer wants to run the tool to look for his brand new one or two warnings when there's 1,000 that are outstanding. Tools like Coverity and others also provide mechanisms that the engineer can focus on his two, while the team as a whole could focus on the other 1,000 that need to get reduced so that you've got a clean build, whether it be, you know, warnings from the compiler or warnings from Coverity or warnings from other tools. And that also is a key ability on why you can introduce this to a large code base, which first time you run a tool like this, you may get 10,000 warnings. If every engineer had to wade through 10,000 warnings, no one would ever use it. But what you can do is allow the 10,000 warnings to be created, and over time chip away at them, but new code that gets created, the engineer would only work with his delta, so that way you can make progress while you're working through the backlog. I think that's a really critical component of almost any tool to make it effective in its insertion in a large or even a small environment.